Hi, I'm Jo, and I'm here to take you through a practice designed to really help you ground and connect with the earth element. So it's really important, particularly at this time of year, when autumn literally blows in with what we call in Ayurveda and yoga, really Vata energy. And when we have too much Vata, things can become physically very dry, and emotionally and energetically very, what I would call fizzy, so a lot of anxiety, a lot of in your head, and feeling very, very away from the earth, not very grounded. And so to just balance that back, it's a great idea to connect with the earth and really feel grounded. So this will be particularly useful if you are naturally a more Vata, air element person. It's perfect for this time of year, the autumn. And it's also really great as well as a full moon practice, which we actually have happening today on the 1st of October. So to feel grounded during a full moon to really help encourage that sense of release. When we connect with the earth, we feel like we can let go and release the stuff that's not working for us. So it's just a really beautiful, perfect time to be embarking on a grounding yoga practice. So practice I'm going to take you through today is accessible for everybody, and you don't really need any props either. So we're just going to begin by sitting cross-legged, close the eyes, take a long spine here, and just bring awareness to the sit bones and the earth, feeling connected and stable and supported. Take a deep inhale, fill the body with prana. Pause at the top of the breath, and then exhale, let it go. And really sink into the earth that little bit more. Inhaling again. Pause and hold. Exhale to release. Breath in. Pause this time for a count of 3, 2, 1. Exhale, let it go. At the bottom of this exhale, close the mouth and start to establish your breath for your practice. That can be a ujjayi breath or just simply taking a breath through the nose that's as long on the inhale as it is on the exhale. And using that exhale, that apana breath, to really feel connected to earth element, finding that stability, that steadiness. And really slowing our practice down. Earth practice teaches us patience as well as grounding us. And using that inhale to draw energy up from the earth to feel strong and empowered. Take 2 more cycles of breath here. Continue with this breath for your practice, but as you inhale, we're going to roll over the knees and come into child's pose to begin. So take the knees wide, hips to heels, extend through the arms, maybe lifting the palms, but bring the forehead to the earth. And have 3 deep breaths here, connecting that third eye space with the ground. Inhale to draw yourself into tabletop. I would just take 3 gentle cat-cow here, inhaling to open the heart and the hips to the sky. Exhaling to coil navel to spine, chin to chest. Inhaling, find length here. Use the full length of the breath to find the end of the movement, the full extension. Exhale to coil. 1 more, inhaling. Exhale. Inhale to come to a neutral spine. Keep the hips in line with the knees. and walk the hands forward. You're going to come to Anahatasana, your puppy dog pose. Melt the heart, the earth, maybe the chin or the forehead come to touch the earth here. Enjoy opening the shoulders. Two more breaths. Inhale, curl up through that cat pose, draw the chin to chest. And as we exhale, take a really slow undulation of the spine through reverse cobra, all the way down onto the belly. We take a pranam here. We bring a prayer above the crown, bring the forehead to the earth. Three breaths. Inhale, draw the hands underneath the shoulders, roll them back, plant all 10 toes, take baby cobra, three breaths here, really connect with Mula Bandha, that root log. One more inhale. Exhale, tuck the toes, hips to heels, come to your first downward facing dog and just have a couple of breaths here, some movement to just find some comfort and stability here. It might be first job of the day, so just take it easy. Check in, see what feels tense, what feels loose. Maybe shape or rub the head, release tension there. One more breath. Really connect with the earth here too. Really spread the fingers, push down through the feet, send that energy up through the hips and down into the heels. Inhale here to send the right leg to the sky. We come to three-legged dog. And as we exhale, you're going to bend the right knee and open the hip. Have a breath here. Enjoy opening up the back of the left leg as well. Squeeze right foot to the bottom. Square the shoulders. Inhale, extend that right leg. Square the hip. Exhale, draw right knee to nose. We hover in plank. Inhale, send the right leg back and up. Exhale, knee to nose. Inhale, send the right leg back. And this time as we exhale, draw knee to nose and step the right foot between the hands. We can help it with the hand if we need to. Drop the back knee. I'm going to inhale to sweep into crescent lunge. Lift the heart here. Keep Mula Bandha engaged. Three breaths. Gaze can be up or down if it's too strong. One more inhale. Exhale, open the shoulders. Come to frame the right foot with the hands. Inhale, step to plank. Exhale to lower the knees, the chest and the chin. Inhale, roll to cobra. Low, medium or high. Exhale, come to downward facing dog. Inhale, left leg lifts. Exhale, bend the left knee, open the hip. Have a breath here. Inhale, extend the left leg, square the hip. Exhale, draw left knee to nose, squeeze the head, lift between the shoulders. Inhale, send the left leg back and up. Exhale, knee to nose. Inhale, one more, really radiate through that lifted foot, ball or heel. Exhale, step that left foot between the hands and drop the back knee. Inhale, rise, come to your crescent lunge, Anjaneyasana. Open and lift the heart to the cosmos. Maybe sink into the hips, but don't lose the connection in Mula Bandha. One more inhale. Exhale, open the shoulders, frame the left foot with the hands. Inhale, step to plank. Exhale, we lower again. Astanga Namaskar. Inhale, maybe this time come to upward facing dog. Exhale, the core takes you back home. Down facing dog. Three breaths. And maybe here we take a deep inhale through the nose. Exhale through the mouth. Use that exhale, that grounding breath.
Inhale, right leg to the sky. Exhale, we're going to step the right foot between the hands. Root down with the back foot at 45 degrees and come to your warrior one. Option here to take a reverse prayer with the hands, cross the wrists, draw the shoulders back. We're square through the hips and the heart, and we're strong in the back leg. Inhale here. Exhale, bring the hands to a normal prayer, and then come down through humble warrior and tuck that right elbow under the right thigh, let the head go. Prayer to the heart. Bend the right knee more than you think. Let the head go. One more breath. Inhale, release left hand to the earth. We're on the ball of the left foot. Sweep the right arm forward. Take it up into twist and lunge. Strong back leg. Lift out that left wrist. Two more. Exhale, bring that right hand down. Inhale, step to plank. Exhale, lower vinyasa of your choice. Stay with Astanga Namaskara, lower chaturanga if you have it in your practice. Inhale, open the heart. Exhale, come to down facing dog. Inhale, the left leg lifts. Exhale, step it between the hands. Root down with the back foot, rise up. Take a different reverse of the wrist. I can never remember. Shh. Three breaths here, strong back leg. Lift the heart, draw the shoulders away. One more inhale. Exhale, draw a prayer through the center, tuck that left arm under in humble warrior. Let the head go. Inhale, sweep the left arm forward and up, come to that twisting lunge. Parivrityanjaneyasana, draw the shoulders back, lift through the left fingers. Exhale, send that left hand back down to earth. Inhale, plank. Exhale, lower down. Inhale, Urdhva Mukha Svanasana, upward facing dog. Exhale, Adho Mukha Svanasana, down facing. Three breaths in. This is the flow we're going to use to warm up, so we're going to repeat those postures. One breath, one movement, two more rounds. Inhale, right leg to the sky, three-legged dog. Exhale, set the right foot between the hands. Inhale, rise. Warrior one, take reverse anjali as an option, it's not obligatory. Exhale, come through humble warrior. Tap that right elbow under, let the head go. Inhale, plant the left hand, sweep the right arm to the sky, we twist and lunge. Exhale, bring the right hand down. Inhale, plank asana. Exhale, lower with control. Inhale, open the heart, boots are on no matter where we are here. Exhale, travel back to downward facing. Inhale, the left leg lifts. Exhale, step it through. Inhale, rise, different cross of the wrist. If you can remember which one we took on the other side, exhale, lower through humble warrior. Tuck the left elbow, draw chin to chest. Inhale, comes the twist and lunge, left arm comes forward and up. Exhale, left hand down. Inhale, plank. Exhale, slow chaturanga or knees, chest, chin. Inhale, come to your back bend. Exhale, downward facing dog. Three breaths here. And we can always take that inhale through the nose. Exhale through the mouth. One more here. One more round. Inhale, right leg to the sky. Exhale, step the right foot between the hands. Inhale, rise, Virabhadrasana one. Exhale, come through humble warrior. Right elbow under right thigh. Inhale, sweep the right arm forwards and up. Exhale, bring it down to earth. Inhale, step to plank. Exhale, we lower. upward facing or cobra. Exhale, downward facing. Inhaling left leg to the sky. Exhale, step the left foot between the hands. Inhale, rise up, change the cross of the wrist if you can. Exhale, come through humble warrior. Left elbow tucks under left leg. Inhale, twist and lunge, sweep the left arm to the sky. Exhale, left hand to earth. Inhale, step to plank. Exhale, lower Chaturanga Dandasana. Inhale, upward facing dog. Exhale, come to your child's pose, knees are wide. Hips to heels, forehead to the earth. Have three breaths. Look up to tuck the toes behind you nice and wide. Walk the hands back and come to Malasana. Come to a squat at the back of the mat. Stay here for three breaths. Lengthen the spine. Draw the tail down to the earth. And just again, make that contact, that engagement with Mula Bandha. Take the feet a little bit wider than maybe you think you normally do. And if you struggle to get your heels down, use bricks, foam blocks underneath the heels. And that will just help you tip back more and lift the heart and the spine. From here we're going to take a twist. Let me show you frontal. We're going to exhale to plant the right arm in front of that right shin, the hand to the side of the right foot. Inhale, send the left arm to the sky. Draw that left shoulder back. Option to stay here or to bind around the right knee. Three more breaths. Inhale to release if you're bound. Bring the left arm to the sky. Exhale, bring it in front of the left shin, plant the hand. Inhale, sweep the right arm up. Maybe it just stays here, or maybe we exhale to take a bind. Four more. Inhale to release if we're bound. We meet here with the right arm lifted. Exhale, bring it down. As we inhale here, we're going to take the hands slightly wider than the feet and bend the elbows. So we're creating a little shell for the biceps and the triceps actually to just rest the front of the lower leg, the shins, just below the knees on there. And as we inhale, we're just going to rock forward, lift off the heels and press onto the backs of the arms. Exhale, tip up. So we're not actually taking arm balance, it's more of a hip opener, but we are just playing with that lifting feeling. Inhale to come up. Exhale to go back. Inhale, one more. Exhale, travel back. And decide here, maybe we come back to our Malasana, feeling very grounded, very connected. Or maybe we want to take a very earthy arm balance, maybe baby the cat and a baby crow. So if we're taking this, it's probably best for me to show you side on. We're going to plant the forearms. We're coming forward, lifting off the heels, traveling forward like we do a normal crow, coming down onto forearms and squeezing to lift the toes, lift the hips, and I'm barely off the mat here. Travel back, we'll meet Malasana here. And then inhale, we're going to come into a forward fold. So extend the legs gently. Inhale to lift the feet, plant the hands underneath. So the palms are underneath the soles of the feet and the toes tickle the wrist crease. We want to press the toes, the balls of the feet into the heels of the hand. So bend the knees if you need to get there, it's no problem. Inhale, lengthen the spine. Exhale, forward fold, chin towards the shins. Five breaths. Inhale to look up, release the hands from under the feet, walk back to your downward facing dog and have a breath here. Use that kind of breath, inhale, exhale through the mouth. I'm going to inhale, sweep the right leg to the sky. Exhale, step the right foot to the top of the mat, look right outside the right hand, we come to a lizard lunge. So the right foot is towards it, right on the edge of the mat. Inhale, drop the pelvis, open the heart. Three breaths here, strong back leg. Maybe you're on finger pads here to give yourself lots of space, even come onto bricks if you prefer. Inhale, one more. Exhale, drop the back knee, extend that right leg. Ardha Hanumanasana, long spine. Let the head relax, take the right hip back. Inhale, come to that low lunge. Open the heart, lift the back knee. Exhale, step the left foot outside the left hand, come back to your squat. Two more breaths here. One more. As we inhale, we're going to plant the hands and just hop back or step back to plank. Take a breath here. And as you inhale, roll to side plank on the left side. So we're opening right side body and take a supported variation of Vashisthasana here. So take the ball of the right foot just behind the left calf and drape that right arm overhead. You're on the side plane, we lift the hips, open right side body. We feel very stable, very grounded. One more breath. Exhale, bring the right hand back to meet the left. Inhale, sweep the right leg into three-legged dog. Exhale, take the right foot under the body, we're coming to fallen triangle. So take it across, out to the left, come onto the skinny edge of that right foot, flat on the left foot, send the left arm to the sky. Three breaths, lift out that right wrist, keep the hips high. Exhale, the left hand comes down. Inhale, sweep the right leg to the sky. And as we exhale, we're going to come through Chaturanga all the way to the earth. And what we're going to do is bring that right knee towards the right elbow. So we're in a kind of crocodile pose in plank. Exhale, lower all the way down. Come into this crocodile, make a pillow for the head. The hands look to the right. Just have three breaths, do nothing here but connect with the ground. Slow it all down. Inhale to draw the hands underneath the heart, the shoulders, and then lift up. Come to low, medium, or even high cobra here. It's quite juicy. Take what feels right for you today. Inhale, press back, lift up through the core, send the hips back. And come to almost like a gate pose here. So let me show you side on. You'll still have the mat in front of you and your right leg will be out to the side. You bring the right arm onto the right thigh, send the left arm onto the diagonal, come to Parshvakonasana here. Three breaths, reach through the left fingers, open left side body. Option to stay here or to take a deeper variation, bringing the right hand inside the right foot, extending the left leg and coming to your posture here, or even taking the bind if you prefer. Three more breaths. Last inhale. Exhale, sweep that left arm overhead. Come to Prasarita, turn the big toes towards each other so you again will be facing the front of your mat. Turn those big toes in. It doesn't matter that the feet aren't on the mat. It's great to connect with the ground, particularly in this practice. We lengthen the spine as we inhale. Exhale, walk those hands back. Level with the instep of the feet. Draw the crown to the ground. Keep the spine, nice and long, 8 breaths. If you want to go upside down in your practice, you're very welcome to do so. Headstand's not the most grounding pose in the world, but if you really love it and you want to take it here, go for it. 3 more breaths. Inhale, roll the hands forward, lift the heart. We come to plank with the legs still wide. We tip onto the toes and we exhale to lower chaturanga. Keep those toes tucked, feet nice and wide. Inhale, come to upward facing dog. It's nice and juicy with the wide leg stance. Exhale, the core takes you back towards down dog. Either hop or step the feet back to hip width. Have 3 breaths here. By all means, inhale through the nose. Exhale through the mouth. Let that right side go. Inhale, send the left leg to the sky. Exhale, step the left foot outside the left hand at the top of the mat. Come to Anjaneyasana here in a lizard lunge. Open the heart, sending that right heel away from the heart space. Yeah. 1 more breath, inhale. Exhale, drop the back knee, extend the left leg. Enjoy Ardha Hanumanasana here. Melt towards the floor with the head and the heart, but lengthen the spine. Inhale, travel back to your low lunge. Lift the back knee. And as you exhale, step the right foot outside the right hand. Come to Malasana. 1 breath. And then inhale, rise all the way up, prayer above the crown. And as you exhale, bring the elbows together. So your palms and your elbows are together, like we make an elephant's trunk here. Inhale. And as we exhale, we sit super deep squat. Ganesha stance, elephant stance. So bring the thumbs to the third eye space. We sit deep. 3 more breaths. One more inhale. Exhale, come back to Malasana. Inhale, hop back to plank. Take a breath here. And then as we inhale, we come to Vinyasa, supported on this side. So just take the ball of the left foot, press it into the earth. Drape the left arm overhead. 3 breaths. Exhale, left hand down. Inhale, left leg to 3-legged dog. Exhale, set the left foot underneath the body, come to forward and triangle on the other side. Lift the right arm, 3 breaths, hips high. Exhale, bring the right hand down. Inhale, the left leg lifts. And as we exhale, we lower through that crocodile plank. Bring the left knee towards the left elbow, come down with control. Take 3 breaths, make a pillow with the hands to the head, look to the left, 3 breaths here, connect and slow down. Inhale, draw the hands under the shoulders, elbows to ribs, come into your cobra here. Again, low, medium or high, enjoy 5 breaths. Inhale, really engage the core, lift up, send the hips back and come to that gate pose stance. So just checking in that that left heel is adjacent to the right knee. Bring the left arm onto the left thigh, come into Parshvakonasana here. 3 breaths, reach that right arm overhead on the diagonal if you can.
option to come into a deeper variation, plant the left hand, extend the right foot, come into posture here. Using that contact between left shoulder and left knee to open the ribcage to the sky more. Exhale, bring that right arm overhead, come back to prasarita, turn the big toes towards each other. Inhale, look up, halfway lift and interlace the fingers behind the sacrum. As you exhale, forward fold here, A breath. Trying to keep the heels of the hands together, let the head go. Bringing tiny increments of weight forward into the balls of the feet to find extra length in the spine. One more breath. Inhale, release the hands, look up. Walk forward, come onto tippy toes, come to that wide leg plank. And as you exhale, lower chaturanga, keep the toes tucked as you inhale to come into upward facing. Exhale, this time we're going to drop the knees, bring the feet together, come to child's pose.
Three breaths here. Inhale, we roll up through cat pose. And as we exhale, just let the legs open as you roll down all the way onto the belly to come into that pranam that we took at the beginning of the practice. Take the prayer above the crown, forehead to the earth.
We're going to take an earthy back bend here. So, draw the hands back towards the body and bring the feet towards the heels. We're going to come to Dhanurasana. So if you can, catch the ankles. If you can't, use a strap or even just come into a variation where you're just more active. You don't have to grab the feet. You can still lift and make that same shape without having the contact of the ankles. And in many ways, it's a deeper, stronger pose that way. But if you can catch the ankles, just try and keep the feet together. They may not stay together, but we want to avoid letting the knees splay really wide apart. Exhale to prepare with the forehead on the earth. Inhale to kick back to lift up. Kick, kick, kick. Five breaths here. Joy. Opening the shoulders, the heart. Exhale, lower gently, lots of control, limping out this pose. Release the feet, take them back to earth. Cactus the arms, look to the right, and just rock the hips a couple of times. And then inhale, bring the right knee towards the right elbow. Come to that crocodile pose. Feel very, very grounded and calm here. Inhale to extend the left arm straight ahead, as though you're swimming or reaching for something delicious. And then bring the right palm towards the face, lift the right elbow, press into that right palm like a lever to turn the upper body only, to come onto your back, shoulders on the earth, that right knee will lift slightly, and just find that point where you're weighted on the diagonal, so you've got rotation in the spine, and we're taking a really yummy twist. Five breaths, maybe the gaze goes to the right elbow. Inhale to gently just come back onto your belly, extend that right leg, cactus the arms, look to the left this time. Bring the left knee to the left elbow. Three breaths here. Inhale, extend that right arm.
Press into the left hand, lift the left elbow, and use that arm as a lever just to take the upper body onto your back. Look to the left, enjoy. 5 breaths here. Inhale, wind the tape, just come back onto the belly. Come back to that prana, just for 3 breaths forward to the earth. And then inhale to roll onto the back. Make your way into Shavasana. Let the legs go long, let the feet flop out to the side, palms to the sky. Take a deep inhale, scrub all the muscles in the body, the face, the fingers, the toes. And then exhale, let it all go, let it all drift away. There's nothing to do and nowhere else to be, just in relaxation. Reconnect with the earth. And I'm going to leave you in Shavasana for as long as you wish to be there. And so my last words are thank you for practicing with me. And enjoy your reconnection with the earth and grounding. And know it's always available whenever you need it. Om Shanti, Shanti, Shanti.